Hello dear students, welcome back to our YouTube channel. As you know that we are studying about integral transform, in which we have completed our first unit as beta and gamma function. In previous lecture we have seen the detailed explanation about beta and gamma function. In today's lecture we are going to solve some examples which are based on the class transform. We have done our theory part and definitions and the class transform of some basic functions in previous lectures. Today we will go through some examples which are based on some advanced theorem of Laplace transform, in which find the Laplace transform of f of t, where f of t is given as t minus 1 bracket square, and 0, whenever t is greater than 1, and t is less than 0, is less than t, less than 1. Now here we have a function f of t, and they ask us to find the Laplace transform of that f of t. And f of t is defined in different interval 0 to 1, which is 0, and from 1 to infinity t minus 1 bracket square. Since we know that Laplace transform of f of t is equal to integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Since by the definition of Laplace transform we have seen the Laplace transform of f of t is equal to integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Then we can break this integral into 0 to 1 e raised to minus st f of t dt plus 1 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Now putting the values of f of t with respect to the limit of integral, so in between 0 to 1 e raised to minus st f of t is equal to 0, so we can write it as 0 dt plus 1 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t is equal to t minus 1 bracket square dt. Now since after multiplication with 0 this term becomes 0, so we can write it as is equal to 1 to infinity e raised to minus st e minus 1 bracket square dt. Now what they have done, they ask us to find the Laplace transform of f of t, and f of t is given as t minus 1 bracket square whenever t is greater than 1, and 0 whenever t running from 0 to 1, or t has value greater than 0 and less than 1. So we will use the definition to simplify this. Now by using df we can solve by integral by part. So by df we have exponential part in last, so we can write it as, since we know that integration of 2 to t is equal to 2 integration of t minus integration of derivative of 2 integration of t. Correct. Dx and dx. So are using here, we can choose p minus 1 bracket square, as it is an integration of e raised to minus s t minus integration of derivative of p minus 1 bracket square e raised to minus s t dt in the whole thing. Right. Now p minus 1 bracket square e raised to minus s t becomes e raised to minus s t or minus s, and integration will become 0 to infinity, 1 to infinity, sorry. That is integration of 1 to infinity, differentiation of 2 p minus 1, p minus 1 square, we will get 2 into p minus 1. Then again, integration of e raised to minus s t becomes minus s t. We will get, we have used here integral by part, and after using integral by part, we will see after putting the value of t as infinity, so we will get t minus minus 1 as outside, t minus 1 bracket square upon t square c, we get the value from 1 to infinity. So we have infinity upon infinity form by using L'Hopital rule. Applying to this, we will get 0 here, and it will become minus minus plus 2 upon s outside, integration from 1 to infinity t minus 1 upon s as it is. Again, using integral by part, we will get t minus 1 e raised to minus s t upon minus s 1 to infinity minus integration from 1 to infinity, differentiation of this, we will get 1 e raised to minus s t upon minus s. Right. So we will get 2 upon s here after putting after simplifying this, we will get again 0 here, then this becomes 1 upon s, and integration from 1 to infinity e raised to minus s. After taking the integration of this, we will get 2 upon s square e raised to minus s t upon minus s 1 to infinity. When you put infinity, we will get 0, and when you put 1, we will get minus s upon minus s, and this gives us 2 upon x cube e raised to minus s, and it is the required result for the Laplace transform of f of t is equal to t minus 1 bracket square for t greater than 1 and 0 for t greater than 0 and less than 1. In this lecture, we have a function f of t which is equal to t minus 1 bracket square whenever t is greater than 0, and 0 when t belongs to open interval 0 and 1. So, as you know that the delta function of f of t is defined by the integration from 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. So, we can break this integral into two parts, integration from 0 to 1 to minus st f of t dt plus integration from 1 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt. Integration from 0 to 1 e raised to minus st f of t in between 0 to 1 is 0. So we put 0 here and plus integration from 1 to infinity e raised to minus st. In between 1 to infinity, we have f of t is equal to t minus 1 bracket square. So we have right here t minus 1 bracket square. Then integration from 1 to infinity e raised to minus st t minus 1 bracket square dt becomes our main part which we have to solve.
Simplifying this, you will get 2 upon s square into e raised to minus 1.
what is that? So this example. In the next lecture, we will try to solve some more example, which is based on Laplace transform. Is that